Reichland Reavers are one of the very best Blood Bowl teams that there are. They're always riding high in the leagues and showing that humans can hold their own against the very best that the competition can offer. Now in this video, we're going to show you how to paint their blue and white colour scheme, and we're going to use a very straightforward method that will have your team ready for action in no time. So without further ado, let's get started. Throughout this video, I'm going to be using a human lineman as our example, but you can use the steps and techniques to paint any member of the team by just following along in the same way. And the first thing that we need to do is paint the majority colour, and that's going to be the blue armour. Now, these miniatures are already cast in blue plastic, but I have undercoated my miniature with Chaos Black Spray, and the main blue we're going to use for this for the first step is going to be Kalidor Sky. Now, as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this using my large base brush as well, because I want to paint, well, the vast majority of the model with this colour. So what you need to do is get hold of a palette, get some of your paint, and put it onto the palette there like that, and then add a small amount of water in. And you don't need very much, especially with a brush this size, just be careful not to get too much there. Mix that in, smooths the paint down, and helps it go a bit further, and also helps it dry smoother as well. And once you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this all over your miniature. And you're looking mainly to catch all the armour panels, but don't worry about other details now because we are going to be neatening up as we go along. And I do recommend applying two thin coats as well to build it up to a good strong finish. Once all the armour's base coated with that blue, the next thing to do is to start base coating all the clothes. And for this you need Rakarth Flesh, and I'm going to be applying this mostly with a small base brush. But for some of the players it's a good idea to have a medium base brush on hand, because some are wearing a lot less armour than others and there's more clothing to catch. And what you need to do, thin your paint down as usual, and just make sure you don't have too much of this on your brush at once, because you need more control now. So once you're ready, all you're looking to do is to pick out all the clothes. Now I'm going to start just here, being careful around that armour there on the chest, just being as neat as I can around those parts. And whilst you're at it with this colour, it's a good idea as well just to catch this bit of thread that we've got on the front of the body armour too. It's being really light just to pick out those raised areas there like that. And I do recommend, once again, that you apply two thin coats. And there we go, the clothes are now base coated, and we're ready for the next step, which is to start preparing for a white detail on the helmet, which we're going to finish off later on. But to start doing this, what we need is Ulthuan Grey and a small layer brush. And what you're looking to do is, once again, use your palette to thin your paint down, and you really don't need very much of this because this detail is quite small. And once you're ready, the area we're looking to paint is this part here, that's either side of the crest. And what you want to do is just neatly as possible paint this in, just being really careful along that line so you get a nice clear distinction between this colour and the blue. That stripe's now painted in, and I also decided to paint the shield design on the back using Ulthuan Grey as well. And now we've got some more base colours to apply, and all these are going to be applied in the same way, so we're just going to run through those quickly for you now. I'm going to start out with Steel Legion Drab for the socks, and then move on to Dryad Bark to paint all the leather, so the boots and belts, that kind of thing. Then we're going to start using metallics, beginning with Retributor Armour for all the gold details on the helmet, and then we'll use Lead Belcher for all the silver details, so things like knuckle dusters, for example. But starting with Steel Legion Drab, I'm going back to my small base brush for this, and once again, you need to make use of your palette to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. So just a small amount of water there, mix that in, and once you've got that ready and not too much on your brush, all you've got to do is start applying this to the socks. As you do this, just be really careful when you get to the trousers to get that nice neat line between the two colours. Next, base coat all the leather details using Dryad Bark, and for this you're looking at the boots and also all of the belts. The next colour is Retributor Armour, and this is for all the gold details on the helmet. So we're looking at the faceplate and also the crest on top. And the final base coat to apply is Lead Belcher, and this is for all the weapons, so things like knuckle dusters, but whilst you're using it, look out for any spikes on the armour as well. Be sure to pick those out. And on top of that, look out for this bar that runs along the top of the shoulder pad as well. And there we are. Now, all these base colours we've applied so far can actually be shaded all at the same time with just Agrax Earthshade, so that's what we're going to do now. And to do an all-over shade like this, what you need is a medium shade brush, and you just need to get a good amount of this onto your palette, so build up a good puddle of it. And there we go. And then once you've got plenty on your brush, all you need to do is start applying this entirely across the miniature. Now, as you do this, really make sure you work it into all the little details as you go, and just keep an eye on it, on the shade as it settles once it starts to dry, because it can start to really run towards the bottom of the model and start to pool around details down there. Now, if it does, just move the excess paint away with your brush and give it about an hour to dry. Now that shade's completely dry, we're ready to focus on painting the skin. And the skin's quite a small detail in these miniatures, and really it varies how much you can see depending on what sort of player it is. But all the skin's painted in the same way using four colours. We're going to start out with a base coat of Bugman's Glow, then we'll shade over it with Reichland Flesh Shade to give the skin a bit of warmth. Then we'll layer it with Cadian Flesh Tone before we finish off with a highlight of Kislev Flesh. But starting out with Bugman's Glow, I'm going to use my small base brush for this, but you might want to have a small layer brush on hand for some of the players, things like the throwers where you can see part of their face, because that's a really fine detail to get to, so you need lots of control there. But once your paint's ready and thinned down, all you need to do is start applying this colour onto the flesh. I'm going to start painting on the arm here, just being really careful now around all those details that we've done so far. Next, apply a coat of Reichlin Flesh Shade over all of the skin. I'm using a medium layer brush for this because this is a very good size to apply this without losing control of it. Once that shade's completely dry, it's time to layer the skin using Cadian Flesh Tone. And what you're looking to do here is to paint most of the skin, but avoid the recesses where the shade has settled the most. So for example, I'm just leaving a dark line there between the skin and the shirt. Same would be true between the muscles and also on the fingers. You're looking just to lightly paint there, so you leave that darker colour showing in between each one. And then finish off the skin with a highlight of Kislev Flesh. And all you need to do is pick out the sharper features, for example the fingers, just some fine lines, just to pick these details out. With the skin complete, we can now go back to painting those colours that we start applying in the first place. And the first of these we're going to finish off will be the blue for the armour. Now to do this, we're going to go back to Kalidor Sky first of all to brighten it back up. Then we're going to do an edge highlight of Teclis Blue. But starting with Kalidor Sky, I'm going to use my medium layer brush for this. And what you want to do this time is use your palette to make sure the paint's under control, because this time we're using this blue. Well, it's a lot more detailed now. So make sure you've got that good tip on your brush by using your palette there. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to apply this over most of the blue armour, but avoid any recessed areas where shade has settled. So for example, on the chest here, I'm going to paint this raised part just there like that, avoiding that little notch we got on the armour. And then leave the shade there and pick up the colour on the other side, just a bit further away there like that. You just need to repeat this process across all the blue for the armour. And with that blue now brightened up, all you need to do is apply an edge highlight of Teclis Blue to finish it off. So you're looking for a fine line following all the sharper edges of the armour. And there we are, the armour is now complete and we're ready to turn our attention to finishing off the clothes. And for this we're going to go for the same sort of two-step approach. First of all, we're going to reapply Rakarth Flesh to brighten the colour up, and then we'll highlight it with Pallid Witch Flesh to complete it. But with Rakarth Flesh, first of all, I'm going to go for my small layer brush for this, and what we're looking to do here is to get the paint under control, because this time the detail's a little bit fine of some of the areas we've got to get to, so make sure you've got that good tip on your brush. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to reapply this to all the clothing, but this time, avoid where the shade has settled the most. So for example, around here, you see I'm just avoiding the deepest parts of those creases like that, just to emphasise the shape of the fabric. Then highlight the clothes using Pallid Witch Flesh. And what you're looking to do here is pick out any sharper creases, for example, just down here, following along the edges of them with a fine line of this colour. Now the clothes are done, we're ready to move on to finishing off the next detail, which is going to be all the white parts. And for this, once again, we're going back to that two-step method. So we're going to reapply Ulthuan Grey first of all to brighten the colour back up, then we're going to highlight it with White Scar. But at this stage, if you want to add some further white stripes to the miniature, well, now's the time. We're going to show you how to do that now. So with Ulthuan Grey, what you need is your small layer brush once more, and again, make use of your palette to thin the paint down. It's especially important with this colour that it's flowing really smoothly. So make sure you got your water mixed in there. And there we are, nice and smooth. And when you're ready, all you're looking to do is to, well, first of all, start applying this once again onto the helmet, avoiding the recessed areas, so you still got that shading showing there. It's a nice bright colour now. But if you want to add those stripes, all you need to do is decide whereabouts you want them. So I'm going to add one in the middle of the shoulder here. Hold the model horizontal and just paint that line straight down like that, keeping your hands as steady as possible. And this is now your guideline to work out from. Just gradually go either direction, adding a bit more to build up that line. If you do make any mistakes, just go back to Kalidor Sky to neaten up. Then apply a highlight of White Scar along any sharper edges. So for the stripe and the helmet, you're looking to paint a line just running along this area here, just next to that recess, just to pick that detail out. But if you added any stripes to the armour, just look for where they meet the edges of the armour plate and just paint a small line along those parts. And with the white done, we're actually nearly finished with all the painting on this miniature, because all we've got left to paint is the metallic parts. So we're going to highlight them now. Starting out with the gold parts, we're going to use Liberator Gold. And then for all the silver parts, we're going to use Stormhost Silver. But starting out with Liberator Gold first of all, I'm going to go back to my small layer brush, and what we're looking to do here is to pick out all the sharper details. So once again, make use of your palette to get the paint under control so it's nice and thin and flowing really easily. And when you're ready, all you're looking to do is pick out those sharper corners. So if I start here on the mask, what I can do here is use the edge of my brush just to very lightly run along there and just pick out that corner there like that. Then repeat this process on all the silver parts using Stormhost Silver. So once again, just following all the sharper edges to pick those parts out. And whilst you're doing this, if you want to, you can also paint the studs on the armour by just touching your brush just to those parts to pick them out with a little bit of silver. And there it is, we've finished painting all the details, and all that's left to do is, well, do the base. But at this stage, if you want to, you can add some transfers to the miniature. If you want to do this, the first thing that you need to do is apply some Art Coat gloss varnish to all the panels where you want the transfer to be, because this is a better surface for the transfer to adhere to, you see. Now, to do this, all you need to do is get hold of a medium shade brush, and it's a good idea to put some of this onto your palette and thin it down with a bit of water, because it is quite thick, and it's also water-based as well, and thinning it down like this just avoids any brush marks appearing once it's dry. So you're looking for about that kind of consistency. And when you're ready, just start applying this to the areas where you want to transfer to go. I'm going to start off in this shoulder pad here. Once the Art Coat's completely dry, the next thing to do is to cut out the transfers you want to use. I'm going for number 11 here. I'm just going to slice around it with a sharp knife. Now, if you're a youngster, remember to get an adult to do this part for you. We now need to wet the transfer, so put it onto some tissue, then give it a good soaking with some water. After about 30 seconds, the transfer will be able to move on the paper, and then we're ready to apply it to the miniature. Paint some water onto where the transfer is going to go, and remember that as long as you keep the transfer wet, you'll be able to keep it moving. And then you just got to do the fiddly part of, well, sliding the transfer from the paper onto the player. So there we go. Now remember, as long as you keep it wet, you can keep it moving around, so you just now need to push it around into position until you're happy. Once you're happy with the final position, use some tissue to gently absorb away the excess water. Then you just need to seal down and mat down the area as well, so just apply a thin coat of Larmier medium across the entire area where you've put on the transfer. The transfers are applied and the base is complete, and with that, this Reichland Reaver is ready to take to the field. So in this video we looked at a fantastic way of batch painting your miniatures, and that is to apply as many base colours as you can and then use one shade to bring them all together. In this case that was Agraxer shade. You'll find that doing this kind of method is a fantastically efficient way of painting a lot of miniatures very quickly. Now when you're applying more delicate shades, things like the Reichland Flesh shade we did later on, always remember not to put on too much at once so that you don't lose control of it. And finally, when you get to your highlights, always remember to be as neat as you can, because the highlights are what really finish the model off. And there you go. Now we really hope that you've learned something from this video, and remember, everything we've shown you can be applied to any member of your human team. So have fun painting them, and we'll see you again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials, and in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?